Guess who? Guess who? You miss me?
Shady 45 is the morning after. I'm Angela Yee, and Eminem is with us. What's up, Marshall?
Hey, hey, what's going on?
All right, so let me tell you something. I went on the Twitter, and I told everybody I would be talking to you, so I do have questions from the people as well. You ready for these?
No doubt, son. Know what I mean?
Now, I was reading about how you said that you were inspired by Lil Wayne and T.I. and their albums. Would you work with Lil Wayne because he very badly wants to work with you?
I would. I mean, there hasn't really necessarily been a time for me to like really get out there and do collaborations and shit lately, because mm-hmm. I've been so locked down in the studio. But I'm open for whatever. You know, there's a lot of artists in the game that I respect, you know, especially right now, because I think I might have mentioned in one of the articles that I did lately that just for a while it seemed like hip hop was not really in a good place for like the, you know, like a good 3 or 4 years. It just seemed to be like, you know, it seemed like all anybody really cared about was making having a dope beat and making a good hook, and mm-hmm. it was kind of no substance. And then it seems to be coming back with artists like, you know, what I've said of lately, with artists like Lil Wayne, artists like T.I., you know, Kanye. I like Kanye a lot too. You know, this, I mean, it just seems like it's getting back to being in a good place again.
Do you like fish sticks?
And especially because I'm, no, I don't. And especially because I'm back, so I think the hip hop will really be in a great place because I'm back.
No, Wed, trust me, we agree with you there. Now, did you experiment on this album a lot? Because obviously, Paul doesn't even have a copy. We haven't heard much except for we heard, you know, Crack a Bottle, We Made You, and I know you just did the 3 a.m. video.
Yeah, buddy.
So, what kind of experimenting is there? Like auto tune or? Any singing?
Yeah, it's a lot of experimenting, a lot of auto-tune, a lot of just auto-tune the entire album.
Any type of singing from you or anything different? I mean, are you sticking
just,
to...
Just listen, just auto-tune.
Just yeah. Auto-tune?
That's it.
Are you serious about that?
No.
I'm not sure.
No, I mean, the only thing that really I got a chance to like experiment on, and this was, by the way, probably the biggest reason that I had a chance to do this is because Dre made all the tracks. You know what I mean? He mm-hmm. produced the whole album, so it gave me a chance to step away from the drum machine and step away from trying to make tracks myself, and it gave me the time to, you know, Dre was making like he made a lot of tracks, and I would get to pick from them, you know, and just kind of go through them, and I tried to pick the ones that challenged me, you know what I mean, like they kind of challenged me like rhythm wise and stuff like that, like you know, I try to experiment with like a bunch of different flows and shit like that, which I usually try to do that every album, but mm-hmm. this album I actually got an opportunity to sit down and kind of go all out with it and try to make every flow different and just pick, you know, unique beats and stuff like that. So
Dre produced everything on the album. You didn't do any tracks?
I did one. I produced one track. I produced We Made You with Dre. Mm-hmm. And I produced one track on the record.
All right. Well, let's talk about the 3 a.m. video. You did that in Detroit?
Yeah. We did that here in Detroit.
And, of course, I haven't heard this song yet. I'm hearing that it's a lot darker than We Made You.
Yeah, it's definitely on a different vibe. I mean, the whole album, I think, is... on a lot different vibe than the actual single.
Now, let me ask you this. Now that your kids are older and they're more aware of everything happening, they have the internet, do you censor yourself more at all now?
No, I actually censor myself less because the older my kids get, the less they like me. So
that's what happens.
Yeah, exactly. So the less cool that is, so that's actually a good thing because I know they don't listen, so they're not listening, so, you know, I can kind of just go freely.
Nice. All right, 888-SHADY45 is the number. Eminem is here with us. It's a grand day on Shade 45.
Okay, like you all know, Eminem is back. What we all need you to do is go to 106 Park, make sure you bring them back, and vote for that new video, We Made You, or Crack a Bottle. We need to bring hip-hop back, and Eminem promises to bring it back. So you got to support him in his journeys. And this is Gents. Tupac's Life Goes On. Look out for Coco 2000 and Slide the Turtle Boy, as well as my friend Hunter C. and we'll come back with more stuff. All right, you sub me, I sub you. Peace.
Back, so I think the hip hop will really be in a great place because I'm back. Back, so I think the hip hop will really be in a great place because I'm back. Back, so I think the hip hop will really be in a great place because I'm back. Back, so I think the hip hop will really be in a great place because I'm back.